Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Rotor-Talk. Tonight's show, I was very excited to have you guys here tonight. This, I hope, will prove to be one of my best shows. I don't know. You guys be the judge. But Jesse Perkins from Tiny Whoop is in the house tonight. Yes, sir. Whoop it up. I'm very excited to have him. It took me a little bit of work to get him here, but he's here. I apologize for last night. Some of you may know, I ended up in the hospital yesterday. Just a minor thing, but it was really painful, and I had to... Nick's last night show, and it worked out because I don't think Jesse was going to be able to make it last night. So he's here tonight, so we're really excited about it. We've also got Peter Ellen coming on tonight. We're giving away this racing drone from Peter Ellen over to Aces Deals, and we're giving away the whole package. You're also getting the IMAX B6 charger with it. Whoops, let me turn that around the right way. And you're also getting the Turnigy 9X radio with it. Yes, you're getting the whole package tonight, courtesy of Peter Ellen and Ace's Deals. And the way you're going to win this, okay, we're not going to give this away until about 5 minutes before the show ends. So, yes, I'm going to make you sit there through the whole show, watch the whole damn thing, and watch me for an hour if you want to win this drone. So how it's going to work is I'm going to give this a number out, okay, this phone number. You're going to have to be a certain caller, and we'll let Peter pick the number. I don't even know the number yet. But we'll let Peter pick the number. Peter, if you're watching, don't pick number 3, okay? It's going to be a little higher number. Anyway, you'll have to be a certain number caller to win this drone, okay? So that's the way it's going to work. So first off, I want to thank my sponsors. I've got a great list of sponsors here. Let's get over to them. I just want to share them with you. And if you guys know me, if you're going to be a sponsor on this show, you better be top-notch like Wheat State Hobbies. I've come to know the owner, Bill, quite well over there at Wheat State Hobbies. He's Air Force vet. He's a great guy. He not only does he operate a hobby shop, but he works full time. Him and his wife, Jenny, he's been in business for 4 years. Just moved and doubled his space. I've done business with him a few times. Wheat State Hobbies, your local hobby shop on your desktop. Give him a click. And of course, Peter Ellen. I can't say enough about Peter Ellen. Peter Ellen's a legacy sponsor of Ace's Deals. And in many ways, this show wouldn't happen without Peter Ellen. I want to thank Peter Ellen over there to Ace's Deals. He's been in business 15 years now, Peter, the way I see it. He's got 51 different drones, 4 repair centers nationwide, open 6 days a week, ships worldwide, impeccable customer service. And on top of that, man, the guy's one hell of a guy. All right, let me just check the chat room just to make sure. How's everything sound over there in chat? How's everything sound? Everything good? Somebody give me a quick hello, or sounds good. Okay, thanks, Josh. I appreciate that. Okay, back to Peter Ellen, Ace's Deals, boldly going where no drone company has gone before. RunCam, everybody knows my RunCam story, so I'm going to bore you with it one more time. When I started this program, I went to RunCam. I've known them for a long time, and they loved the idea, and they what they did was they gave me some cameras. They sent me some cameras to give to you guys, and I've got some here I'm going to be giving away. This is the one of the ring cams are going to be giving away. I've been showing this for weeks. We're going to do it on a future show. But I can't thank Ring Cam enough for their sponsorship. They really believe in Rotor-Talk, and we're right up front. I didn't even have to ask. Within the first few words of my pitch, they was like, what can we do? How many cameras do you want? So again, thanks to Ring Cam. Raycon Heli, Kwok Dung, he's one of our newest sponsors. Welcome aboard to Raycon Heli. He's going to be giving away some frames, some of his quality frames. If you know RC, you know Raycon. And, of course, my friends over there at RC Logger, they're having a great sale going on right now on the RC Navigator 250, which is their racing drone equivalent. It's also a good all-around purpose AP, aerial photography drone. So check out RC Logger over to www.rclogger.com and tell them Ed sent you. And let's see, did I forget anybody? I got RC Logger. Yeah, I got all my sponsors. So, Tiny Whoop in the house tonight. Yes, Jesse Perkins over to Tiny Whoop's going to be on the line in just a few minutes. We're going to talk with him at length. I'm really excited to learn about his whole adventure and everything. And I just want to go over a couple things here. Yes, Rotor-Talk is looking for some correspondents or field contributors. If you're out there racing, grab a mic, grab a camera or your phone, do some interviews, we'll put them on the show. If you want to promote your club, your page, your frame, your whatever, very open, hit me up and we can do something. And let's see. Also, I want to put out a big thank you to our producer, Luciano Menente. Without Luciano, none of this would happen. Luciano's gone above and aboard with Extreme RC TV. RC TV, to me, Extreme RC TV is the Facebook of RC. It encompasses everything. It encompasses everything from the RCA groups, from all the different forums, from all the different RC pages and groups on Facebook. It encompasses everything. It's not designed to replace Facebook or anything like that. It's designed to accompany it. You know what I mean. So welcome to Extreme RC TV that's hosting this platform. And again, a huge thank you, Luciano, buddy. I hope you're listening. You know I'm talking to you, man. I know the wife had plans for you tonight, so I'm not sure you're listening. But if you are, thank you very much. Without you, this wouldn't happen, and I speak for the entire RC community. What you've done is huge, and what you've done is bold. So thank you very much. And again, just my pledge to you. Some of you people may not know me. Some of you people may be new to the show. We've been in beta testing all summer and spring, and I've been trying to figure out what works and what doesn't work. And I've got a pledge to you. The Rotor-Talk pledge list is we'll only have reputable sponsors. I'm an RC pilot. I am for the RC pilot first. Everything else is a secondary to that. Okay, so I'm happy if I'm flying anything, even a little SEMA helicopter or a Traxxas Alias on up to a Phantom or anything in between. I don't care what it is. I'm happy if I'm flying. So we are RC pilot oriented, and that's you. If you're an RC pilot, you're in the right place. And again, welcome. Now let's see. Nothing will stand in the way of Rotor-Talk's mission, which is to bring you content, news, question and answers, and an occasional prize or a contest to give away. Mutual respect is very important here, and it will always be exercised. I will never degrade or belittle somebody's opinion or whatever, and that goes for everything. Now, knowledge will never knowingly or falsely give you information or betray your trust. Again, this show is for pilots. If you're an RC pilot, you're in the right place. So again, I want to welcome you aboard. Rotor-Talk is on the web. We're also on Instagram, Twitter, and if you would be so kind to go over to Rotor-Talk's Facebook page and give us a like. If you excuse me for a minute. Spot of tea. If you go over to Rotor-Talk's Facebook page, give us a like. If you go to Extreme RC TV's Facebook page, give us a like. If you go over to Ace's Deals, Peter Ellen's Facebook page, give us a like. Any of my sponsors, RC Logger, Wheat State Hobbies, Run Cam, they all have Facebook pages. Go over, give them a like, say, hey, I saw you on Ed's show. It was good. It was bad. Whatever it is, just give us some love and some acknowledgement. Some people told me, Ed, you can't do this. Well, I always say, and I think it was Ben Franklin who said, for those who are telling somebody they can't do it, get out of the way of those who are doing it. So again, welcome to Rotor-Talk. And that's all I got for you now. Now, there's some hell of crazy drones out there these days. One of my friends, Alloy Anderson, PM'd me just as the Parrot Disco had come out. And then a couple days after, the GoPro Karma, and then the DJI, what was that DJI one? I can't remember. And then all these other ones started coming out, and I was like, boy, Alloy's point was, boy, those people at DJI must be really ticked off, you know? They thought they kind of had their thunder stolen with all these other big names coming out. And over on Rotor-Talk's page, I've got a little bit of a poll going on, and it lists out the new dramas, the GoPro drama, the DJI Mavic, the DJI P4, I threw that in for giggles because it's still relatively new, the Parrot Disco, and then the Dobie and the Teal drone. Did anybody see these Dobies and Teal drones? I had some pre-show video that was going on. It was quite amazing. That Teal drone, I think it was doing some things that, if it's true, if they live up to what they say, they'll be amazing products. So anyway, let's see. I didn't have a video of the week this week. I couldn't find something that was appropriate, although there were a lot of Tiny Whoop videos you guys were watching pre-show. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to raise up Jesse here. Jesse, if you're listening, I'm going to call you right now on Skype. All right, Rotor-Talk land. I want to welcome Jesse Perkins from Tiny Whoop. We're really excited to have you. We have a lot of people online right now. that are actually tuned in, so I'm really excited about that. Jesse, welcome to Rotor-Talk.
Thanks, it's a pleasure to be here.
Great, we're glad to have you. Now, what I want to do is I want to go back to where it all started for you. What was your first RSC, and bring me up to today?
Well, a lot of people watching probably know about Ben Shepherd. He is the tiny little musician. He's actually sitting right next to me, if you want to get in there.
Yo, is. Ben!
Ben Shepherd, the famous tiny little musician. He writes incredible music, but him and I are old friends, dear friends in high school. We started flying RC. I think we skipped class and drove down from Fort Collins to Boulder, Colorado. And on the way, we stopped at like a Target and bought some cheap RC planes for like $20 each. And they were really hard to fly, but we had a really fun day flying. And ever since then, we've just been stepping it up. And then as soon as the quadcopter technology was available, I think Ben was the first one to jump on that. And he started flying a quad rotor, as he called it back then. That was before some pretty serious advances in software that would make quadcopters a lot easier to fly. And as soon as they did, we were both flying a lot. I started out on a Proto X, which everybody knows, that little tiny, I think it's like a $30 Amazon aircraft.
Wait. You started on the Proto X?
Yeah. I think a lot of people did.
Okay, go ahead.
So I started in micros, and I had a blast, and that's about the time I was really getting into it. Drone Nationals 2015 was announced. Me and three really close friends that flew together almost every day started what became Team Big Whoop. And to prepare for Drone Nationals 2015, we designed the XBR, which was a very popular airframe. It's the kind that looks like a box with an X in the middle. Right now I'm at Ben's house, which is Tiny Whoop headquarters, so I don't have the aircraft here.
Right.
We're talking mini quads now, so.
Right, I know what you're talking about, yeah.
Yeah, so we flew, Drone Nationals did great, and Team Big Whoop made a fairly big splash, so we decided to, I think everybody that went to Drone Nationals 2015 decided to get pretty serious about drone racing. So we went back home, just sort of on fire, decided that we were going to become the team that traveled to every major race we could get to, and since then, we have been to, I think every major race that anybody watching could list in their mind, Team Big Whoop has been there and probably wound up on the podium at almost all of them. And it was at the Phoenix Cup that we started giving out Tiny Whoop stickers. So Team Big Whoop started out as, we were really well known, you know, we're good friends with all the top pilots, and we do Drone House, we travel around and we stay with these guys, and right now a lot of them are coming to Fort Collins to stay with my teammates Zach and Jordan over at the Big Whoop headquarters just on the other side of town. And we made a major sticker campaign at the Multi-GP Nationals for 2015. And so we pretty much went there with a ton of Big Whoop stickers and put them on everybody and everything, every trash can, every post, every gate, everything. And so stickers kind of became our thing. And as a joke, I started making little tiny stickers that said Tiny Whoop on them, just right, as a play off of Team Big Whoop. But sometime later, after the Phoenix Cup, it was actually at Drone House, I believe, 2.0, where I met, it was at the Phoenix Cup Drone House where I met Ori Pomoni, who is an excellent pilot. He flies all kinds of drones, but he's an excellent micro pilot. And he was the first one to recommend to me that I put upgraded motors on the Inductrix airframe. That was an awesome choice because, first of all, the flight controller is outstanding and feels very tuned in. It feels like very natural flight for a lot of people that are just coming into the hobby. And if you put the right motors on there and a good camera, it's safe, it's fast, it's agile, it's maneuverable. I mean, everybody watching already knows this. I bet they're Tiny Whoop pilots. And now the Tiny Whoop can do tons of things that nobody's ever been able to do. You know, not just complicated maneuvers through your house, through the trees, but you can also safely fly really close to children.
Yeah.
We were flying tonight around Ben's two kids. How old are your kids, Ben?
1 and 4.
1 and 4 years old. So little Isabella, 1 year old, barely on her feet. And she loved it. You know, little kids have this instinct where if you fly up to them with a tiny whoop, they just start to reach for it. Like they want to grab it, you know. And this is all stuff that we could never have done with quadcopters or FPV rigs before. And that's been really exciting. And so I started the Tiny Whoop YouTube channel, was sort of how it all started. The initial idea was Ben, who, like everybody knows now, is just an amazing songwriter, and he writes songs every day. He writes, you know, anytime he's driving in his car, he writes a song using his iPhone because he's just full of musical ideas. So the original idea was...
Are these the dirty type of songs me and you make up, or are these like... No, I'm kidding, Ben. I'm kidding.
I don't think they tend to be clean. Okay. Not. Ben, he probably writes some dirty songs. I don't know. Anyway.
Sorry, I digressed.
Not at all. So we decided we're going to make a YouTube channel that involves all of my piloting on the Tiny Whoop. It's going to be mostly DVR footage, which, you know, nobody's really doing a YouTube channel of 480p footage, but. Found a way to make it pretty entertaining. It's a pretty simple format for videos, and we use Ben's music. And after we got a couple videos out, it really took off in a way that nobody expected, that I didn't expect. I mean, looking back now, I think the popularity of the Tiny Whoop makes a lot of sense. But at the time, I didn't see it blowing up the way it has. So since then, Tiny Whoop has taken over the world. There's something like, I think the Facebook group is now 6,600. It's the largest micro Facebook group in the world. And tinywhoop.com is now a thing. We've got a little store there selling some Tiny Whoop parts, including we make ready to fly aircraft so people don't have to build them. But I always encourage people to build these things because it's easy, it's cheap. The build takes about, you know, maybe 15 minutes if you're really slow, maybe a half an hour. You know, even if you're learning to solder for the first time, it's a really easy build. It's an awesome introduction into building and into flight. And in the case of the original Inductrix flight controller, there's absolutely no tuning. So that's one of the three major learning curves that people just skip right over when they get into FPV through the Tiny Whoop. And I think that is so nice. Building, I see the three learning curves of FPV as building, tuning, and flying. And tuning is difficult. Building was a big learning curve for me. I had never soldered before I started building XBRs.
Right.
And, you know, now I've done a lot of soldering. Tuning, I'm still pretty awful at, but I've got some awesome teammates who always lend a hand, and I've learned a lot from them. But it seems like tuning is the kind of thing that it's hard to be an expert at tuning. You kind of have to use a lot of trial and error and sometimes get lucky. But like I say, all of that is irrelevant to most Tiny Whoop flight until the recent release of the B-Brain flight controller, which is a clean fight beta flight controller for the Tiny Whoop. Until then, everybody who wants to, and you know, since then also, can use the Inductrix flight controller or the Inductrix FPV flight controller in their Tiny Whoop and have awesome success on their first flight. Yeah. So,
yeah, no, that's awesome. I can relate because, you know, with FPV racing, you can't always go to a field and set up a bunch of gates and, you know, it's raining or it's just not convenient, to be honest.
Or maybe,
you know,
maybe it's after dark, you know, maybe it's winter.
Right.
Tiny Whoop has absolutely no limits. And you know, I love that because I fly all the time.
Yeah.
I fly every single night. You know, there's no reason not to take 2 minutes out of your life, no matter what you're doing, and rip around and practice flying. You know, we've got little hoops everywhere. It's just so easy to spend 2 minutes with your brain totally focused on the gift of flight.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's such an awesome part of my life now. And now an awesome part of a lot of other people's lives too.
Oh, yeah.
So that's sort of the story of Tiny Whoop. Since then, there's been Tiny Whoop Facebook groups popping up all around the world. There's a huge one from Malaysia. The French group has 600 members. The German group has 500 now. There's Tiny Whoop every country you can think of. If you look it up on Facebook, there's probably a group of people talking in whatever language about the latest Tiny Whoop you know, flights or the latest technology, latest micro technology, which now, partially because of Tiny Whoop, the technology of these cameras and the flight controllers and even things like airframes and propellers, are it's all moving forward much more quickly than when Tiny Whoop began, because a lot of people around the world recognize the market that is opened up now, which is good, because, you know, we really want smaller FPV cameras, lighter FPV cameras. We really want stronger, more reliable, longer lasting motors that give us the punch we're looking for. And as a side note, I'm really hoping that Tiny Whoop will do everything it can to push forward the action camera revolution, because I know I'm not the only one dying to see high definition come from these tiny, safe things. A lot of the shots I get, they're really special because they can be really sweet or sort of intimate or full of action or very tight spaces. Yep. And we've never seen that kind of thing in HD even today, but I think it's coming soon. I think we're going to see HD reach the micro level very soon. That's going to be an exciting day.
Well, how small do you think these Tiny Whoops can get? I mean, do you think one day we'll have the Tiny Whoop flying thumbtack? I mean,
who knows how small they can get, but right now it's looking like smaller and smaller. Some people are making Tiny Whoops out of Proto X's now. That's very, very small. I think the Tiny Whoop itself is a 66 millimeter diagonal motor to motor.
Yeah.
That's probably small enough for most people. I mean, hitting a 7 centimeter gap versus a 5 centimeter gap or a 4 centimeter gap, those are fairly similar. Although I have to say, every time this technology gets smaller, the world gets bigger. Yeah. And every time you step into, you know, a Tiny Whoop and you fly around a room just the size of this one, this is Tiny Whoop headquarters located in Ben's house. You know, there's just shelves. It's a mess right now, but this is a vast terrain for the Tiny Whoop, worthy of being tamed by any pilot. So that's what we're having so much fun with.
So I'm sure you would agree, and this is basically directed at our newer pilots, that I found when I flew my Proto X inside, that my precision and skill as a pilot just quantified quickly. I could go outside, and my precision outside as a pilot was dramatically better in a short amount of time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, I mean, I fly most of my Tiny Whoop flights in the past have been done in angle mode. Now with the B-Brain, rate mode, also known as full manual mode, is way more feasible and way more fun. This opens up the doors to, you know, urban building divings. I spent one Saturday morning going all over town. I dove every single tall building in my town, and nobody ever got upset. I mostly made friends all day. In fact, I only made friends all day. Everybody that I talked to became a friend of mine. So, most of my flight with the Inductrix or with the Tiny Whoop has been in angle mode. And most of my flight in mini quad racing, which I'm also very serious about, has been in rate mode, full manual mode. And I'm still really surprised how much of the skill of flying a Tiny Whoop transfers to or translates to rate mode. I mean,
dramatically.
So it's kind of like my brain now speaks two languages, but it can translate between those two languages, you know, very quickly. There's not much relearning. When you start to do a certain kind of maneuver with aggressive flight on a Tiny Whoop, which you can fly a Tiny Whoop very aggressively and do very difficult, complex, dynamic maneuvers, when you want to translate that to a mini quad, it's surprisingly easy. Even though, you know, when Tiny Whoop took over the world, it also took over my life, and I'm used to flying a lot more mini quads than I have for the past couple months.
Right.
But I recently passed through Netherlands on the Tiny Whoop 2016 Euro Tour, and we went to a race at Riverside, and I hadn't flown a mini quad in a little while, but I did great there and had so much fun on this cool course that was sort of like, it reminded me of a Tiny Whoop course, because they had like a crane holding a gate way up in the sky.
Awesome.
The kind of stuff that you can only do this stuff with. Yeah, it was great. You can only do a lot of that with Tiny Whoop equipment. You know, when you get to Tiny Whoop, it becomes really easy make a gate like this.
Right.
You could put it up in the sky or something, but you can't easily do that with a mini quad. Or
right.
learn to dive down, you know, picture a course that would be the equivalent of diving through a basketball hoop in a tiny wood.
Right.
That would be a really expensive course to make if you were flying in a mini quad.
Yeah.
But with a tiny whoop, it's like a couple, it's like, you know, for this balloon gate that I guess I'll talk about. We're just about to start, you know, I'm trying to get a lot of people to make courses with this new balloon gate. So this is, you know, a 2 cent balloon. You can get them online. I'm about to start selling them, but it's not a product that I'm going to make much money off of. I'm mostly just trying to get it out there to see people make awesome courses with these really simple balloons. You can blow like 100 of them up in 5 minutes and just make the most amazing courses.
Great idea. So and, that was where I was going to lead next to is let's drill down and let's talk about tinywhoop.com. And let's talk about, you know, there's a lot of places now to buy a tiny whoop. Let's talk about the differences, let's say, if I bought a tiny whoop from your website as opposed to somebody else, if you don't mind.
Not at all. There's tons of people making tiny whoops right now. Or at least tiny whoop style aircraft is I guess, what I want to say. There are a few things that set the tiny whoops that me and Ben and our other partner, Jared, build that sets them apart. We reinforce, let's grab, this is Ben's personal aircraft. So we reinforce this frame in 12 really important parts. These little, the spot where the strut that holds the motor mount to the duct is a super weak common breaking point that I think everybody watching right now is probably nodding their head and saying, yeah, my tiny whoop broke. So, and I've, every single tiny whoop I've ever flown has broken there, except for the ones that we reinforce. And we use a product called Welder. It's very cheap. You can get it anywhere. You can get it on Amazon.com, delivered overnight. I sell some of them now. And that makes the tiny whoop a different aircraft because you feel more free to do take more risks and fly faster without having to worry about breaking those really weak struts. Other than that, you know, a tiny whoop, for those that don't know, is pretty much the Inductrix control board, Inductrix frame and props. We upgrade the motors and we upgrade the battery. And we found, you know, what is so far the perfect, the best out there FPV pod is this. It's called the FX798T.
I'm sorry, FX what?
798T.
Okay.
So other than those things, the main difference between the tiny whoops that we build and the tiny whoops that other people build are the motors. There's some places out there that hype their motors as being extremely fast but don't offer any statistics and very little footage. We have, these are the Tiny Whoop Race Edition motors are 14,800 kV, which I think is the perfect balance between flight time and performance. They're extremely fast. Punch outs are very strong. Especially if you go with a lighter battery, although the most popular battery, of course, the MyLiPo 205.
Right.
This is an awesome battery.
What's flight time on that?
It's between, I'm going to say between 2.5 and 5 minutes, depending how you fly. A lot of my flights recently have been the kind of flights where if you crash, you're not going to get your tiny whoop back. So I do a lot of my flights just very short. I keep it around 2 minutes and, then I come home and switch batteries because I got a pocket full of batteries. I got a few batteries that I roll with.
Right.
So tinywhoop.com, Tiny Whoop TW1 is what we call this aircraft. It's in my opinion, after all of my experience, this is the pinnacle of micro FPV. It's the most control you can have. It does, you know, a lot of people get started with Tiny Whoop using Inductrix ready to fly, and that comes with an awful transmitter. I don't think I have any nearby me right now. Actually, I do. Here's one. This is the transmitter that the Tiny Whoop comes with, or excuse me, the Inductrix comes with, and the Inductrix FPV. And I find this thing to have awful resolution. The sticks feel weird, but the biggest problem is you just don't have control. There's very few clicks. And it feels like your quad is not fluid. So I always recommend upgrading something like this. This is a Spectrum DXE. It's a $60 transmitter, cheapest full-size six-channel transmitter out there. And these sticks really feel a lot better.
Yeah, there is a difference.
And double your control easily. I mean, people think I'm exaggerating, but it's literally twice the control. When I learned to fly on this thing, I felt like such a fool when I finally graduated to something like the DXE or the DX6 or a Tyrannus with an orange module. All those options are just so much better as far as control. So I highly recommend that to anybody, even as a beginner. What's up, Ben?
Hey.
Even as a beginner coming into Inductrix flight or Tiny Whoop flight, I would not, unless I was forced to, I probably wouldn't waste my time on this. What this is good for is learning what sticks do what. So if you know that already, I suggest skipping this phase, and I wish I would have, because I thought when I flew this on some of the early Tiny Whoops I built, I assumed that that was all the control you could get out of micro flight, but I was very wrong.
Yeah. Well, you've gone down the same learning path that we have. We've all got those junk controllers.
Yeah, the toy transmitters.
Yeah, we've all been there. So, you know, you're going down the same path that any RC pilot that's dedicated is gone. So it's not unusual for sure. So, all right, so let's talk about the Tiny Whoop website.
Sure. Let's,
tell me what's new. Tell me what's going on. Bring me up to speed on Tiny Whoop.
Ben, will you grab the mullet mono I built?
Sure.
We just released, you know, I spent all day here at Tiny Whoop HQ pretty much releasing all kinds of products we've been getting in. We got in a rainbow of colors for the camera mounts. We got these mullet mods made. This one, I just, you know, thrashed it in the grass so you could see how mullet. Yeah, it's very
like
slick. I really like this build a lot.
That looks cool.
Not any faster. It's more of an aesthetics thing. It's also really nice because if you're using a stock antenna, which we also just started carrying a lot of other antenna options, which I recommend because this thing is pretty weak. But if you're using a stock antenna, a lot of people damage these lobes at this breaking point, just where the lobes attach to the mast.
Right.
And If you put your antenna VTX kind of cocked back like this, you're much less likely to damage those because you can't really impact back here very easily unless you're flying backwards all the time. We just started, you know, these balloon gates I mentioned. We're trying to get a bunch of people to build excellent courses with these. We started carrying these transmitters today. Ben's working on a new camera mount as we speak right now. He's printing one in the printer just beside me. A new camera mount for the Inductrix FPV, because we found that in some of our flights with that new aircraft, we really wanted more camera angle.
Right.
And that's not possible with this thing. This is a zero camera angle frame that comes with the Inductrix FPV. So we're working on a camera mount.
What's the field of view on that stock camera?
Field of view is the same as most of the Tiny Whoop cameras. I think it's 120 degrees.
Okay.
Fairly soon, tinywhoop.com will also be carrying much wider lenses and much narrower lenses just for people to play around with. I'm the kind of guy that loves a very wide lens because I want to see the gate around the turn before everyone else. To do that, you know, to get ultra wide, to get, you know, some people have trouble with the 120 degree field of view is wide angle. And it messes with your brain a little bit when you're learning how far away something is. It seems like initially people don't realize how close something is because of the spread they can see. If you go really wide, something doesn't look close until it's right next to you. And that's something that you have to sort of train your brain to get used to. So one of the missions I'm on is to get extremely wide, to give my brain all that extra information and not be tripped out by a strong fisheye effect, which is something that your brain just has to get used to.
Yeah, I don't mind the fisheye. I really don't.
No.
Some people have a hard time with it. It doesn't bother me one bit.
I think it looks great, especially when you're moving fast forward.
Yeah.
The part that trips some people up is in a hover, turning or looking past someone's face. Their face gets kind of big or weird and distorted on the side. But my brain doesn't even notice that anymore, and I'm trying to take baby steps to get wider and wider.
Yeah, if you're a child of the 70s, face melting doesn't look unusual to you.
So yeah.
Okay, well, let's see. So is that new? Is that all that's new from the Tiny Whoop store for now?
No, it can't be. Well, we're about to start carrying. We're going to sell some of these and Dark Tricks FPVs, Flying Flies, and Ready to Fly. What else is new, Ben? We've got so much new stuff. That list over there somewhere.
You got the different colored camera mounts?
Yeah, we got the rainbow colored camera mounts. I think we went over. Yeah, I think it's probably all the stuff we put out recently.
And it's all available on your website, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me just plug your website. There. Hold on, give me just a minute here.
Yeah.
Let's see. There we go. Here's the website, folks. www.tiny-whoop.myshopify.com.
No, actually, it's just tinywhoop.com.
Tinywhoop.com. Okay, I don't know why I came up with this. But
It redirects, you know, part of the website is on a Shopify because there's a little shop there. But yeah, tinywhoop.com is where to go.
Okay. So let's see. I think that's it. Let me just bring you back here. There we go. All right.
I like that infinity effect that keeps happening over there. That's crazy.
Yeah. all right, let me just see if there's any questions. Anybody have any questions? No, it looks like you covered pretty much everything.
Nice.
Jesse, I thank you for – I really thank you for appearing on Rotor-Talk tonight.
Hey, my pleasure.
We're fledgling. We're just starting out. But, you know, I hope for this to really take root and get bigger. And if you're interested in sending some of your contacts my way to spotlight them, I'd be more than happy to do that too.
Yeah, I'd be happy to. I fully support the project. And like you said earlier in this episode, what Lou is doing is really cool. I love Lou's website, extremerc.tv. This seems like it has a ton of potential.
Yeah, yeah. So spread the word, post it on your Tiny Whoop. He wants to know, by the way, you reminded me. He wants to know when you're going to get going on the Tiny Whoop on the site, or if you guys are going to be expanding that out, or if you have an assistant in media relations that's going to, you know, pull the thread on that, so to speak.
Yeah, we're working as fast as we can right now. We are a little inundated with projects, and I really am excited to be a part of ExtremeRC.TV and get tons of Tiny Whoop live streaming. I am so excited. This is a platform where a lot of different people can share or live stream their Tiny Whoop flights for anyone who's watching. And right now, you know, Tiny Whoop is getting more and more popular. We see the numbers and the growth itself growing every day. There's a lot of new people interested in different flight styles. And the idea that people can share flights live so easily it's excellent. I mean, it's going to change a lot of people's flight styles.
You know what's good for – what I really like about RC flying is even people who are disabled are able to do it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, a lot of my friends are in that situation, and a lot of the people I met through the hobby are in that kind of either a health or a physical disability-related situation, and they have found new freedom in FPV flight the same way everybody else does too.
Yeah, I myself am legally blind in my left eye, so.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not, no. But I'm a damn good pilot. I'll say that much, so.
I bet you are. And all you right. had some kind of a health issue last night. I'm sorry to hear that. I wanted to tell you.
Oh, yeah.
I hope everything's better.
I thought it was kidney stones like I've had before, but it wasn't. It was something else. But I'm on the mend, so I appreciate that. Well, I'm going to wrap this up because I got a drone to give away. So if you want to stay tuned, we're going to give this drone away. And
I will.
Really thank you for joining us tonight. I'd love to have you back again.
Please have me back.
If you could do me just one thing, I'm going to record you right now. I want you to just say, this is Rotor-Talk Live with Ed Lyons.
You want me to say, this is Rotor-Talk Live with Ed Lyons?
I want to get a promo from you.
Sure.
Yep, just look into the camera and say, this is Rotor-Talk Live with Edward Lyons.
All right.
Go ahead.
This is Rotor-Talk Live with Edward Lyons.
Thank you very much. I got it. All right. Thank you very much, Jesse. Thank you so much for calling in tonight. I appreciate it. I really do. Give Luciano a plug on if you can for the Extreme RC TV as well.
I will. And I want to say for anybody watching, if you have any questions or need any help with the Tiny Whoop, don't hesitate to hit me up on Facebook or Ben. We're always anxious to help people out and make new friends. So, yeah, reach out.
All right. You guys hear that out there? All right. Thank you very much, Jesse, and I'll look forward to talking to you again soon.
All right. Bye-bye.
Good night. All right. That was Jesse, as you know, from Tiny Whoop. We're very excited to have him here tonight. And I'm going to take just a two-minute break so I can go to the bathroom and wet my whistle, and I'll be right back. I'll put some music on, and we're going to give away this drone. Peter, if you're out there, I'm going to be calling you in just a couple minutes. So let me get some music on here. I need a break real quick. Here we go. Thank you, Jeremy Beasley. It's one of them damn things. I do it every week. You didn't miss much. I was thanking the sponsors, Raycon Heli, Aces Deals, Peter Ellen, Weed State Hobbies, Run Cam, and of course, RC Logger. We're all thankful very much for the sponsors. All right, I'm going to call Peter right now. Peter, I'm calling you. We're going to give this away. Here we go.
I'm calling him right now, Ed.
Okay, thank you. All right. Thanks for holding on, everybody. Peter's giving him a call.
Hello. How are you, sir? There you go. Well, you are the winner. I apologize. Ed had a hard time with his phone, you know, when you called. So I'm not sure if you heard him. So, but thank God he was able to retrieve the phone number. So that's why I'm, you know, calling you myself. But Ed, I've got the winner on the phone right now. What was your name again, my friend? Hello? Jeremy, what was it? Jeremy what? Jeremy Beasley is the winner. Where do you where do you come from, Jeremy? Where do you live?
Congrats, Jeremy.
You're in Virginia. Okay.
He's an ICE officer, Peter.
I'm sorry, what was that? No problem. All right. I'm going to grab some information from you. If I could just grab your, well, I've got your phone number, Jeremy Beasley. And Jeremy, what will happen is when Ed gets his phone situation straightened out, he'll give you a call tomorrow, get your shipping address and everything else, and then you and him can figure everything out. But, you know, I just want to say congratulations on behalf of Rotor Talk, on behalf of Aces Deals. And thank you for watching the show. Very good. Well, thank you. Thank you, sir. Call me anytime if you ever need anything. Have a good night. Bye.
Thank you so much, Peter, for doing that. Thank you for sponsoring Rotor-Talk. And thanks for sticking through this mess tonight with the technical gremlins, so I appreciate that, sir.
No problem, my friend. You have his phone number. His name is Jeremy Beasley.
Okay.
He lives in Virginia.
Yeah.
It's a Montana phone number. I did the wrong area code when I Googled it.
Oh,
but he's
okay.
Looking forward to your call tomorrow, and you're all set.
All right, Peter. Well, that's Peter Ellen from Aces Deals. Thank you so much, Peter. Have a good
have
night.
A good
I know
night,
it's late.
Everybody.
Tell Mama Ellen I thank you. Thank her for letting me steal you away.
You got it, sir.
Good night. Thank you again.
Good night.
All right, folks. That will conclude this episode of Rotor Talk. I appreciate you watching in. Sorry about all the technical glitches and difficulties. Next week, don't forget, we have Ben Hack, calling in from the land down under. If you don't know Ben, tune in next week. He's quite a remarkable RC pilot and innovator and builder and all things RC. Runs his own engine, RC motor company. So join us next week on Rotor Talk for Benjamin Hack. Thanks for Thanks for watching tonight. I'm a little flustered with all the technical demons, but again, thanks for watching tonight, and we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching Rotor Talk. Over and out.